age 17, future Dr. Clean. I am my mother's eldest daughter. I recently graduated from high school, and we were celebrating this as well as my acceptance to college. I was a good girl. I didn't mess around with boys, and I was very respectful. Even though my father wasn't around, I amounted to something. It was time for my mother to make her speech. "Well, Nora is a good girl," she said into the poorly tuned microphone. "She has never caused me any troubles. And do you see my house? How tidy it is. She can clean." Terrible people can be good mothers, but can terrible mothers be good people? Age 18, sickle, faint signal. It wasn't sickle trait, starved red blood cells bent into bastardly shapes that made me faint. Someone asked me if I ate, but it was too late. Collapsed on the lecture hall floor, I remember being carried through the door. The doctor looked at me, and I tried to focus my vision on her between long blinks. She said, "Is there a reason to think that you don't want to eat?" My mother eventually saw my dorm room refrigerator, and I don't relish being her guide on that tour. I thought stale graham crackers and water was all that she left for her daughter. "Sickle trait came from your father," she remarked, as if there was honor in living longer or making fodder. It wasn't sickle trait that almost killed her daughter. It was hunger. Age 20, social experiment. I needed to eat. That was why I started taking those flyer strips. Every day, I would stare at the bulletin board while waiting for classes to switch. The dollar signs were impossible to ignore. And I was curious. Maybe I'll find out something interesting about myself by taking part in those research studies. For science, right? This study paid $1,200. I would have to stay at the hospital for 2 nights, but I convinced myself it was a paid vacation. I purposely didn't read the fine print. I was chasing the easy money and willingly ignored any possible risks. What I didn't know couldn't hurt me. When I arrived, the nurse told me to change into shorts so that they can access my thighs. "Why?" I asked. She looked at me vacantly. "So we can put in the probes for the readings." It was painful at first, then the probes became just an absurd alien appendage. I sat in the hospital bed with 3 needle probes inserted parallel to the skin on my left upper thigh, right underneath the muscle. I try not to look at them, and I try to shift for comfort and for science. On the third day, I climbed the hill from the hospital back towards my apartment. I was $1,200 richer at the beginning of a summer in Gainesville, Florida. I would be able to pay rent. I would be able to eat. And after all, I did it for science. Age 22, cat allergies. I'm allergic to cats, even though I love them. I learned this early on, sneezing repeatedly on living room rugs. My eyes would water and swell, blurring my vision. Coughing for air, each breath felt like it was closer to my last. But I still loved cats. After every exam in medical school, I had the habit of visiting the local box chain pet store to stare at the cats, watching them sleep, eat, and play. I would tap on the windows lovingly. It was a temporary escape from the pages and the computer screens. And I was lonely. But this time was different. I usually went alone, but some classmates decided to tag along after a particularly brutal exam. We had all stayed up all night the night before studying, and we were almost delirious, dazed by the morning sunshine after that test. When I walked down the aisle, I watched her awaken and stretch like an Egyptian sphinx, with her mouth agape in a silent lion's roar. We both approached the plexiglass partition at the same time, and she bumped her head slightly and against it softly, inviting me to play. I remember the laugh that I let out. It must have been the first time in what felt like ages. I touched the barrier, feeling her warmth as she danced and pressed against the other side. She likes you. You should get her, Michelle exclaimed. This wasn't surprising, considering she had plenty of assorted pets herself. I'm allergic to cats, I replied to her. Take medicine, she said with a chuckle. And I considered it. Daria purred, and our eyes met in an intense gaze. Age 25, the right thing to do. Would you marry me anyway, is what she should have said that day. Kneeling on the grass with engagement ring in hand under the cherry blossoms as the children around us played. I would marry you anyway, so why delay? I don't want the shame of tainting my family's name. Motherhood. The magic of giving birth is not the creation of life, but of pain and death. By having a child, I meet another person who will die. I will have to watch as he is tainted by living. I cannot protect him as I thought I could when he was in my womb. He sees me furrow my Botox brow and tries to comfort me. If only he knew. But one can only know And one can only learn from experience. And by then, it's too late. Age 33. Apologies. My mother never apologized. People say that it's because she's Nigerian. It's not in our culture for a parent to apologize to a child. I apologized all the time for everything, including my own existence. The last time we spoke, my mother's words stung excruciatingly. "You and your father have made me suffer," she said. She wouldn't apologize. "I have never done anything wrong," Nneka later told me that she said on the phone. "I once questioned my sanity because I waited patiently for an apology that is in a dial tone." Psychiatrist. A broken mirror still shows a reflection, though fragmented. Let me find the biggest piece so that you can see yourself and fit together the rest. I am a psychiatrist. I just want to play one thing for you. It is a song that resonates in my head, and it's the wish that I have.
First day of spring, every heart.